We are back here in Haslett for the second part of our doubleheader between the Haslett Vikings and the visiting Red Wings of St. John's. St. John's just won the girls' game. The boys' game about to get underway. We have just announced starters for Haslett is Tahaney, Sleeper, Allen, Holton, and McCarthy. For the Red Wings, it is Hudak, Rossfield Posh, Benfield Posh, Stevie, and Paxson. So looks like Sleeper will be taking the tip-off for the Vikings. And for the Red Wings, it will be Paxson. This one just about to get underway. Haslett comes in here at third place in the CAAC Red. St. John's in fifth place. Haslett is 7-7, 5-2 in league play. St. John's is 3-10 overall, 1-6 in league competition. That ball last touched by Red Wings. It'll be Haslett ball. Tahaney will take it up top now. He finds Allen back over. Quick ball movement as usual for the Vikings. That's a three-point shot for Brandon Allen, and he knocks the first attempt of the night down. Here's Hudak. He gets it down low into Paxson. Paxson not able to get the lob. That's going to be deflected off of McCarthy, who gets it over to Holton. This is now McCarthy again to Tahaney. Back to Holton. Brandon Allen with the ball again. Here's Tahaney to Sleeper. Sleeper goes up for a jumper. He's not able to hit it, but a rebound by Tahaney. Not able to save it before it goes out of bounds, and it'll be red ball. Here's Phil Posh. He goes over to Ross, his brother, who finds Paxson. Here's St. John's, who gets it down low. Outside now to Hudak. He goes cross-court for a three-point attempt from Paxson. And here's Brandon Allen going down the court. He pulls back. Here's Tahaney to Sleeper. Sleeper goes up for two. St. John's quickly goes down the court. Paxson down low. He goes up for two and gets the first 2 points for St. John's. Brandon Allen with it again in the wing. He gets a ball screen from Holton. He won't use it. He gets double teamed. This is McCarthy in the three. Not going to fall. It will be St. John's ball going the other way. Here's Field Posh, back to the other Field Posh. He gets it down low to Paxson. Paxson goes up, gets swatted by Holton. Tahaney with the ball now. He dishes it over to Brandon Allen, who drives in, takes on four defenders. Not going to fall, but it's going to be St. John's ball. Let's take a look back at that three-pointer from Brandon Allen, the first shot of the game. Never mind, we'll get that to you later. This is Feldposh, he's going to take it up. He gets it down low to Stevie. And here's Hudak. Over to Ross Feldposh. He gets it to Hudak, to Ben Feldposh. Holton tries to get a hand up. That's a rebound by Paxson and a putback. Haslett averages 68 points per game, St. John's 52. But the last time these two teams met, it was a much higher scoring game than their usual. It was a 90-80 game. Haslett winning that one at St. John's. Here's Tahaney. He goes up for a shot. Not going to go for him, and it's going to be St. John's ball. Full court pressure coming now for the Vikings. St. John's has no trouble with it at all. They get into Hudak. Here's Paxi. Paxi goes up and gets another 2 points. He has all 6 points now for the Red Wings. Haslett's going to have to try and find some way to stop him from getting as many points as he is so far. There's a steal from Field Posh. That's Ben. He gets two. Tahaney gets it into Allen. Brandon Allen's going to slow it down a little bit. Finds McCarthy in the wing. McCarthy trying to dribble. That's going to be an over and back. St. John's ball. Fiorillo will come in now for the Vikings. McCarthy will take a break. This is Ross Fieldposh throwing it in to Ben Fieldposh. It goes over to Ross, down low into Stevie, to Paxi. Paxi does another turnaround. Not able to get that one to go, but he gets his own rebound. And it's going to be another St. John's possession. Here's Stevie. He swings it up top to Ben Fieldposh. Back to Stevie. Stevie's going to drive in. He goes up for a little floater, not going to fall. And Tahaney gets a rebound. It's a three on three. Sleeper for three. He drains the bucket. Paxi down low again. Not able to hang on to it. It's poked away by Tahaney, but it'll stay with St. John's.
Second for the Vikings. Number 14, Avery McKinney.
McKinney will come in now for the Vikings. Holton will take a break. Ross Fieldposh throws it into his brother. Here's Hudak, who finds Ross. Paxi down low, he gets blocked. Here's Tahaney to Allen. Allen goes up for three, and he's on fire tonight. Here's Hudak. He gets it down low into Stevie. Here's Brandon Allen. Allen goes, he drives in, he's going to get fouled. Here's a replay of Brandon Allen's three-pointer. Brandon Allen will be shooting free throws. Knocks down the first one.
Checking in for the Vikings, number 32. Ryan Wheeler.
Harden comes in now for the Vikings. And he goes 2 for 2 from the stripe. It's going to be St. John's ball. Fieldposh with it. He'll drive in. Looks like he took an extra step there, but he's going to get a foul called for him. That foul going to be on Harden. Fieldposh gets it in to his brother. He goes up for three, not going to fall. It's McKinney to Fiorillo. Fiorillo finds Sleeper in the wing to Brandon Allen. Brandon Allen takes a step back, breaks his ankles. There's Sleeper for three. Not going to fall, but a good rebound by McKinney. Here's Allen for another three-pointer, and he knocks it down. Already at 11 tonight, and it's only the first quarter. Paul Fiorillo with a nice steal. He's going to get fouled. McKinney gets it into Brandon Allen. Allen finds McKinney to Harden. Harden's going to drive. He gets blocked going up for the layup. It's going to be going the other way. Wheeler with it. Wheeler gets caught up on the rim. Brandon Allen going the other way now quickly is Haslett. Transition offense is both what these teams strive in. That's why the score was so high the game that they did play. Here's McKinney for a three. That's in and out. And here's Fiorillo. Here's Ben Feldposh. He gets blocked up. That's going to be a jump ball called. Take a look at this three-pointer by Brandon Allen. He gets it kicked out, goes over the top of Hudak. Not even phased, and he still makes the bucket. That is why Brandon Allen is the most deadly player in the area. Here's Tahaney up top now. Just over 30 seconds remaining in this quarter. Brandon Allen with it. He's going to take a dribble. Looks like he might hold on to it for the final shot. Just over 10 seconds now. He's going to get a ball screen from McKinney. 3 seconds left. He finds McKinney down low. Not going to go. And a full court shot coming for St. John's. Nowhere near. And that's going to wrap up the first quarter. It's an 18-10 lead for Haslett. We'll be right back at the start of the second. You're watching the Haslett Media Production.
The most heart-stopping, game-changing, tie-turning moments of high school sports. Under Armour Highlights of the Week on the NFHS Network.
Olive Garden's 20th anniversary of Never Ending Possible. So we're celebrating by offering you over 20 delicious choices starting at $9.99. Like our new homemade chicken pomodoro sauce, creamy pesto alfredo, and toppings like crispy chicken frita. Plus, enjoy unlimited super salad and breadsticks. Hurry, it's all never ending, but only for a limited time. 20 years of Never Ending Possible. Over 20 choices starting at $9.99. At Olive Garden, we're all family here. Breadstick lovers, your new favorite lunch is here. New breadstick sandwiches.
We are back, and it's the start of the second quarter. It has lit up by 8. So far, Brandon Allen is the story. He's shot 3 for 3 from the 3-point line. He's got 11 points already in this one. To break the Haslett all-time scoring record, he needs to average 15 points per game in the remainder of the season. He averages about 26 per game, so he shouldn't have too much of an issue with that. And already at 11, he's already almost on his way for this game. Here's Tahaney with the ball now. He'll bring it up for the Vikings. Tahaney drives to the wing. Brandon Allen was the target there, but he was double-teamed. Good decision making by Tahaney not to get it to him. Harden gets it up to Tahaney. Haney's going to drive in, and he'll get a bucket. St. John's going the other way. Haslett's going to come up with it. St. John's down a person. Haslett not able to capitalize with the man down. That's going to be a timeout called. We'll take a timeout as well. It's 20-10 Haslett's lead. You're watching Haslett Media Production.
You know, the Greek philosopher Aristotle said, you are what you repeatedly do. But in our book, we say you are what you repeatedly do when things get hard. When you look at the naysayers and the haters, and there's a million of them, but you take it upon yourself to erase all doubt. Get that doubt out of here. So my apologies to Aristotle, but excellence doesn't become a habit by running the same path over and over. The excellent ones just step up to the line and ask, what's the record? Under Armour, get your feet straight.
We're back here, and I just want to take another look at that drive by Dehaney. He goes through one defender, and then while he breaks his ankles, he gets another swipe in there, but he's not phased, and he goes up and hard to the hoop and gets the 2 points, given Haslett a 10-point lead. Here's Hun. He gets it over to Jury. This is Paxi now. He gets it out to Hun again. Back to Paxi. Paxi finds Jury. Jury goes out to Stevie. St. John's doing a nice job of trying to get it down low. Paxi, their main scorer so far. He needs to keep making his points to keep St. John's in this one. Here's Brandon Allen. He goes up for a little bit of a circus shot. Still gets the ball back, though. Good offensive rebound by Haslett. Dehaney with it. He gets it to Holton. Takes a handoff to Brandon Allen. Gets it back to him anyways. And he gets another two-pointer. St. John's back on the attack. Here's Stevie to Paxi. Paxi gets a two-pointer. There's Brandon Allen now. It's going to be a foul called on Stevie.
His first, Steve's third. Entering for the Red Wings, number 12, Alex Budek.
Sleeper going to get it in. He gets it into Holton. Holton tries to get a reverse layup, not going to fall. It'll be St. John's on the offensive. Here's Hudak over to Ross Feldposh. To Stevie. That's going to be a foul call. Take a look at this replay by Brandon Allen. Another long shot for him. Able to knock it down. He's shooting lights out 100% from three-point line. He's got another bucket from field goal range. That last foul was called on Paxi. Here's Dehaney with it. He's going to try and drive in. Hudak able to get the steal. And he gets it down to Paxi. Paxi shoots it up a three, and he knocks it down.
Three for Paxi.
The big man can shoot. Here's Brandon Allen with the ball now. Paxi's at 11 points now with that made three-pointer. Brandon Allen shoots up a three. Not going to fall. Hits a back iron, and that's his first miss from the line tonight. Full court pressure coming from the Vikings. See how Ben Feldposh reacts. He gets it to Hudak, who finds Ross Feldposh. Not going to fall, and it'll be a Haslett ball going the other way quickly. Some quick ball dribbling from Brandon Allen. He kicks it out to Sleeper. Here's Dehaney now. To Brandon Allen. Brandon Allen breaks some ankles. Tries to get it to Holton. Holton gets his own rebound. That's going to be a jump ball call. It'll stay with the Vikings. 4:05 left in this half. Sleeper will try and get it in. Sleeper gets it into Dehaney. The Brandon Allen in the wing. Brandon Allen shoots up a three, and he knocks that one down as well. He's past the 15-point mark that he needs to average per game to break the school record. And it's only the second quarter. Here's Ross Feldposh. He gets a down low to Paxi. Paxi goes up, and he gets the bank to fall.
2 points for Caleb Paxi.
Brandon Allen with the ball again. Trying to extend this lead for the Vikings. Here's Tahaney with it. He goes to Holton. Here's Brandon Allen for three. He knocks down another three-pointer. And St. John's quickly goes the other way to Ben Feldposh. He finds Paxi. He's going to get hammered by Brandon Allen. Now take a look at Paxi's shot. He can shoot the ball. He can get it down low and get a layup. He can even shoot the three-pointer.
On the line for St. John's, Caleb Paxi.
Paxi will be shooting two here. Knocks on the first free throw.
Entering for the Vikings, 13, Evan Harden. And number 14, Avery McKinney.
And he goes 2 for 2 from the line. Paxi is 6'5", giving the Vikings a little bit of trouble. He's already at 15 points on the night. Jake Tahaney, he drives in, dishes it out to Brandon Allen for another three-pointer. Not going to fall. And it'll be St. John's ball. Here's Ben Feldposh. He goes up for a two. Not going to fall. That's going to be a foul on Paxi. Push on Evan Harden. That's Paxi's second. St. John's cannot afford to have him foul out. He'll take a break. Kenny going to throw it in to Tahaney. Tahaney gets it to McKinney, to Brandon Allen. Brandon Allen drives in, he gets a layup. Oh, never mind, he's going to get called for a charge. No bucket. Here's Ben Feldposh now. Coach Smith can't believe it. Here's Book swinging it around for the Red Wings now. That's a steal by Tahaney. See if he can finish it. Not able to finish it. He was too far under the bucket already. Tough shot to make. Here's Ben Feldposh. He'll take a step back and shoot it. He'll knock down the shot. Only two scorers so far for St. John's. Ben Feldposh and Paxi. Paxi is on the bench right now, the lead scorer. Here's Sleeper. That pass is going to get stolen away. Ben Feldposh will take it up. They're going to pass it around. Here's Book for three. Not going to fall. He bricks it. Sleeper gets the ball and goes up to Tahaney. That's going to be a carry called on Jake Tahaney. Coming in now for the Vikings is Connor McCarthy for Jake Tahaney. Here's Ben Feldposh. He goes to Book. That's going to be a illegal screen called on Dyer.
Number 50, Hayden Dyer. His first, he's sixth.
One more foul and Haslett will be in the bonus. 55 seconds remaining in this half. Here's Sleeper. Sleeper goes up for two. He gets it to fall. Here's Ben Feldposh. It goes to Ross Feldposh. Up top the boot. This is Ben Feldposh. Most likely will hold it. Some defense coming from McCarthy. Almost got him in a 5 second. Double team now coming in. It's going to be a foul on Brandon Allen, and you can't believe it. It's Brandon Allen's third foul. He cannot afford to foul out. Both lead scorers for both teams are in some foul trouble already in this one. There's Hudak. Hudak kicks it out. That's going to be a three-point attempt for Book. Not going to fall, but an offensive rebound. And that's going to end the half. It's 30-21. Coming up at halftime, we're going to have a look at the Haslett dance team. We're going to take a look at their performance. And then after that, we will have some features for you that include our Haslett basketball video rosters and the MHSAA Battle of the Fans. Scores 30-21. Let's listen in to the dance team. From the Haslett dance team. Once again, the halftime score is 30-21. Haslett's lead. We're going to come back at the start of the third quarter. You're watching the Haslett Media Production.
What does it mean to be a true fan? Fan is the abbreviation for fanatic, which Webster's defines as one marked by excessive devotion to a cause or idea. Yeah, that sounds about right. For the last 4 years, the Michigan High School Athletic Association has scoured the Mitten for the best fans in the land. The mission of the Battle of the Fans contest is to find the top student cheering section in the state. Are you ready, kids? I can't hear you! Being loud, as you can imagine, is a prerequisite, but first and foremost, it's about promoting positive sportsmanship, student body participation, school spirit, originality of cheers, organization of the group, student leadership, and, oh yeah, fun.
We've really found that the culture is starting to change at schools in regards to sportsmanship around the state. We've got a number of schools that have been involved, and they tell us, their administrators tell us, just how their hallways have changed, their games have changed, and I think it's because it's become kind of a fun and cool thing to do on a Friday night.
Schools were encouraged to produce up to a 3-minute video highlighting their student section. From there, 5 finalists were selected and a public vote was held on Facebook, Twitter, and the MHSAA Instagram pages. Say cheese! At that point, it was up to the Student Advisory Council and MHSAA representatives to determine where the next BOTF championship banner would reside. The student sections from Yale, St. John's, Dowagiac, and 2013 winner Buchanan and 2014 champion Beaverton made the finals. Each had one last chance to state their case.
Getting everybody together, getting loud, going crazy all night long, running the skits perfectly, and just doing what we do every day. And that's win.
Basketball team's first. Whether we win or lose this competition, it doesn't matter. We help the community and we help the basketball team, and those two goals are done. But a secondary objective, winning that would be cool too.
We're back and better than ever.
Yeah!
Loud. Fun. Enthusiastic. Togetherness. How do you pick just one? Well, you go with the most united.
I'm proud to be a chieftain.
Give me a D. Give me an O. Give me a, heck, we'll be here all night. Congratulations to the Attack of Dowagiac, home of the best fans in the state of Michigan for 2015.
We are back here in Haslett. Second half about to get underway here. A couple of statistics from the first half of the game. For the lead scorers, anyways, Brandon Allen, he's got 19. He's shooting 33% from the field goal range, but that's not where he's getting his points. He's getting his points from the three-point line. Shooting 71%, he has 4 three-pointers already in this game. Free throws, he's made 100% of them. He hasn't had too many, though. On the other side, their lead scorer, St. John's, is Paxi. He has 15 points. He's shooting 56% from the field. He's attempted 2 threes, made one of them, and he also is shooting 100% from the free throw line. Those two are the only two players to have shot free throws, so both teams are 100% from the free throw line. Ironically, both teams have 2 people in foul trouble early on, and they're the lead scorers, Paxi and Allen. Brandon Allen has 3 fouls. Paxi has 2. Those two players are going to need to watch where their hands are going in the second half, make sure that they can stay in this game for the remainder of the time. Neither team can afford to lose either player. Haslett has had four players score at least 1 point. On the other side, St. John's has only had three. Not that big of a difference, though, because only two players on Haslett have scored more than two, and only two players on St. John's have scored more than two. Nonetheless, the score is 30-21. Haslett with a 9-point lead as we start this second half. Looks like Ross Feldposh will throw it into his brother now. And the second half is underway. This is Ben with the ball. He gets it down low to Paxi. Paxi gets stopped. There's Hudak. He gets it over to Ross Feldposh. Back to Paxi. Paxi tries to get it into Stevie. Not going to work, and it'll be Haslett going the other way. Nice behind the back by Brandon Allen. Brandon Allen finds Sleeper. Looked like he was going to hand it off to Tahaney. Instead, he'll take a shot himself. Not going to fall. The St. John's going the other way. Ben Feldposh again will set it up for the Red Wings. Ross with the ball. Over to Stevie. He gets it down low into Ross Feldposh. He'll get a bucket for his own. Brandon Allen now with the ball up top. He'll drive in with a little step back. Won't fall for him. St. John's with the ball now, trying to cut into this Haslett lead. This is Ross Feldposh. He gets it over to Paxi. Paxi goes up. Not going to fall for him. And that'll be Tahaney with the rebound. Brandon Allen drives through three defenders and still gets the bucket, putting his total to 21. Here's Hudak. Hudak goes to Ross Feldposh, to Ben Feldposh. It's going to be a foul called. Foul going to be called on McCarthy. This is Ben Feldposh with the ball. He gets it down low to Paxi. Paxi tries to go up with it. Not going to work for him. It'll be Haslett going the other way. Brandon Allen with it now. He gets a ball screen from Will Holton. He swings it over to Holton, who gets it to Sleeper down low. Sleeper goes up for a shot. Not going to fall. It'll be St. John's ball going the other way. St. John's gets it quickly down the court. Find Ross Feldposh for three. Brandon Allen now gonna take it up again. Some tight defense from this Red Wings. Not gonna fall for Holton, and it'll be the other way now. Neither team really scoring all that much so far in this third quarter. Hudak tries to get it over to Stevie. That's going to be out of bounds. Last touch by Haslett. Ref's going to say off the fingertips. Coach Smith not at all pleased with that call. Ben Feldposh with the ball. Over to Ross Feldposh, to Stevie, to Paxi. McCarthy tries to get the steal there. He's not going to get it, and Stevie's going to get fouled going up for the bucket and will make it as well. That foul on McCarthy is at two. There's Stevie trying to make the three-point play the old-fashioned way, and he does. Tahaney will take it up now for the Vikings. Haslett student section now on their feet. It's a 3-point game. It was a 9-point game at half. Sleeper now with the ball. McCarthy drives in hard. He's going to get fouled going up for the shot. Looks like he may have been blocked, but the refs will call it a foul. That's going to be on Stevie, his second. McCarthy will be shooting two. Knocks on the first one. Connor will be attending Central Michigan next year. He's not sure what he will be studying, but he knows that he will be going to CMU. Knocks on the second free throw as well. Still 100% free throw shooting for both teams tonight. Some full court pressure almost going to cost St. John's, but they get it down low. That's a 3-point shot for Hudak. Here's Brandon Allen now. It's a 2-point game. This has a lead nearly diminished. Brandon Allen will be shooting free throws now after that hard foul.
Number 12,
Hudak with the foul. Brandon Allen will be shooting the two shots. Makes that one. And that's the first miss of the night from the charity stripe. Here's Ben Feldposh. He goes over to his brother Ross, who finds Paxi, to Stevie. Stevie goes up top to Hudak, not going to fall for him on the shot attempt. And Tahini flies down the court. He goes, finds McCarthy in the corner. McCarthy for three, not going to fall, and it'll be a good rebound by Stevie. St. John's looking to pull within one or tie the game up. They find Paxi down low. He's going to get fouled shooting. That foul on Sleeper. Paxi is 100% from the free throw line tonight. He makes the first one. That's his first points of the half. And he knocks down them both. His last 4 points have all come from the free throw line. Brandon Allen now with the ball. Coach Smith looking on. That's going to be out of bounds. St. John's ball. This is Ben Feldposh with the ball. He goes over to Hudak, to Paxi, to Stevie. Stevie finds Ben Feldposh, who goes down low to his brother Ross, who gets absolutely swatted away by Luke Sleeper. Sleeper's length and height is so deadly, so hard to make a shot against. He has so many blocks for this Vikings team. He's truly a defensive force to be reckoned with. Just as Haslett scores, St. John's gets another attempt on the other end. Here's a 3-point. That was NBA range for Brandon Allen. Let's take a look at that. That block by Luke Sleeper. So St. John's is going to bring it down. they get down super quickly, and when they go up for the field goal, for the layup, sleeper blocked them. Haslett just called a timeout, or excuse me, St. John's just called a timeout. Worried that this game might get out of hand quickly. They're going to be talking about stopping Brandon Allen. Obviously, that shot was not something that he can make every single time. That was an okay shot to allow, but the rest of the shots need to be stopped by Brandon Allen. He's already at 25 tonight, shooting 75% from the three-point line. Here's Ben Felposh. Here's Ross Felposh for three. Dehaney now. He'll drive in himself to McKinney. Here's Brandon Allen now. Brandon, you can tell, is feeling it. Here's Sleeper for a long two. Not going to fall. It'll be St. John's ball. Just over a minute and a half left in the quarter. Here's Ross Felposh. Here's Paxi to Stevie. Here's Ben Felposh. Felposh pulls up for a jumper.
For Ben Felposh.
We'll knock it down. That makes it a four-point game. Brandon Allen with the ball. No hand in his face. They need that. That's what their coach has been shouting out. That's going to be a five-second call. Coach Smith can't believe it. I don't disagree with him. I don't understand how that was a five-second call. He was driving. So Ben Felposh will bring it up now for St. John's. He finds Ross, who finds Stevie. Kicks it out to Hudak. That's not going to fall. Harden with a rebound, and McCarthy the other end with the ball. Here's Brandon Allen now. Sleeper gives him a ball screen. He goes up for a floater, not going to fall. St. John's with under 30 seconds remaining in the quarter. Here's Ben Felposh. Ben Felposh looks to drive. No shot. It's going to be on the ground. Still on Haslett. 16.5 seconds left. Paxi to throw it in. St. John's under 15 seconds remaining. Ross Felposh goes up strong with it, gets his own rebound and gets 2 points. Brandon Allen tries to get it down to McKinney. He's going to get stolen away, and that'll be the end of the third quarter. So a 9-point lead, now just two. Heading into the fourth quarter, we'll be right back. You're watching the Haslett Media Production.
It's another fall Friday night, and your kids should be
playing high school football.
It's a fun game, and it's safer than ever.
It's safe because the rules, the coaching, and the equipment are better than ever before.
As a result, serious injuries are at an all-time low. Seriously.
And builds.
Strong schools, lifetime memories, and tomorrow's community leaders.
And it's mother approved.
It's a great game, and we want to teach it to your kids.
We're back here in the fourth quarter, about to get underway. About 8 minutes remaining in this one, at least in regulation. 2-point game. This one could go either way. Far too early to call it. McKinney will take it out, throwing it into Tahaney. Tahaney to Sleeper. He hands it off to Brandon Allen. Allen drives up. He's going to get fouled going up for the shot. He'll be shooting two free throws. Brandon shooting 75% from the free throw line tonight. He knocks that one down. And he makes them both. Going the other way now is St. John's. Here's Ben Feldposh. He goes over to Hudak. To Ross Feldposh. To Hudak. To Stevie. Stevie drives in. He's going to get fouled by Sleeper. Took a hard fall there. That's Sleeper's third. He needs to be careful. Stevie knocks down the first of two coming for him. He's shooting 100% from the line tonight. He's not able to hit that one. It'll be Haslett ball going the other way. Jake Tahaney with it. He finds McCarthy. McCarthy finds Tahaney on the give and go. Gets it to McKinney for another 2 points. Here's Ben Feldposh. He gets it over to Hudak. To Ross, back to Ben. Ben for three. Gonna fall to the ground. Dahaney with a rebound. There's Holton to McKinney. Pops it out to McCarthy for three. That's gonna be off to the right. And it'll go the other way to St. John's. Here's Ben Feldposh. To Stevie. Here's Ross Feldposh. That's going to be 2 points for Ross. Brandon Allen will take it now. He takes a step back and drains the fall away shooter. Here's Hudak. Over to Ben Feldposh. Ben Feldposh drives. He's going to get that to fall. Brandon Allen now with it. It's a 3-point game. Has a lead. Another deep three. Not going to go. He made one of those earlier in the game, but that one probably not the best option for Haslett at the moment. Here's Hudak to Paxi. Not going to fall for the big fellow. It'll be going the other way for Haslett. Brandon Allen with the ball now. Just over 5 minutes. Here's Holton now. Holton drives baseline. Gets his own rebound. He gets a 2-point bucket. It's going to be a timeout called by Haslett. We'll take a break. You're watching Haslett Media Production.
It's
It's Olive Garden's 20th anniversary of Never Ending Possible. So we're celebrating by offering you over 20 delicious choices starting at $9.99. Like our new homemade chicken pomodoro sauce, creamy pesto alfredo, and toppings like crispy chicken frita. Plus, enjoy unlimited super salad and breadsticks. Hurry, it's all never ending, but only for a limited time. 20 years of Never Ending Possible. Over 20 choices starting at $9.99. At Olive Garden, we're all family here. Breadstick lovers, your new favorite lunch is here. New breadstick sandwiches.
We're back here, and it's the fourth quarter, 5 minutes left in this one. Let's take a look at this step back shot for Brandon Allen. Gets a hand in his face. He doesn't care. He's going to take a step back, create some of that room, and he'll get 2 points. Here's Ben Feldposh with the ball now. He'll get it over. Down low to Stevie. Here's Paxi. Paxi's not going to get that one to fall. It'll be Harden going the other way now for the Vikings. Harden finds Tahaney. Tahaney will drive low. That's going to get loose. Go the other way. There's a steal. Swat away by Holton. The steal officially goes to Tahaney. Here's Brandon Allen with it now. He's going to get it down low to Holton. Holton goes up for two. Very strong at the rim there. Not a lot of players would be able to make that shot, but Holton made that one look easy. There's Paxi. He gets the jumper. There's Brandon Allen now. There's a little bit of fancy maneuvers. Here's Tahaney, and he's going to get fouled going hard to the hoop. Take a look at this pass right here. He drives in, gets it all the way over to Holton. To have the mindset to see that Holton is over there is an amazing trait for any player, let alone a player with the skill set of Brandon Allen. He will definitely be playing in college where he does not know yet. Speaking of Brandon Allen, he has the ball right now. He'll take a 3-point shot right there, not gonna fall for him. Starting to cool down a little bit, which is expected. No player can continuously hit 3-point attempt after 3-point attempt from that range. Here's Ross Feldposh. He finds Paxi. Over to Stevie. Stevie finds Ben Feldposh. That ball stolen away by McKinney. He finds McCarthy. It's a one-on-one situation. He's going to go up and get fouled. Ben Feldposh thought he got all ball, but the call is going to go against him.
Bob Redwing, 22, Ben Feldposh.
McCarthy shooting 100% from the free throw line. It's 2 for 2 on the night. Knocks down that one as well. Have another one coming for him.
14, Jack Fox.
And McCarthy hits them both. 4 for 4 in the night, and there's going to be a timeout called by Haslett. As they take a break, we will too. Haslett's up by 7. We'll be right back. You're watching a Haslett Media production.
It's another fall Friday night, and your kids should be
playing high school football.
It's a fun game, and it's safer than ever.
It's safe because the rules, the coaching, and the equipment are better than ever before.
As a result, serious injuries are at an all-time low. Seriously.
And builds.
Strong schools, lifetime memories, and tomorrow's community leaders.
And it's mother approved.
It's a great game, and we want to teach it to your kids.
We're back, and it's just over 3 minutes left in regulation here. 7-point game, still anybody's game. Don't want to call this one too early. Haslett's going to obviously continue to try and get good looks, try and get more shots on the board. Brennan Allen almost at 30 points. He's at 29 right now. See if he can break that plateau. If he does so, he will not need to score in the next game to reach his goal of breaking the school record of most points. Obviously, he will be scoring next game, so it will be an added boost for him. It's going to be St. John's ball taking it out. Ben Feldposh looks like he will be the point guard on this next possession. Feldposh goes to the wing. He goes to Boot. Not able to fall, and it'll be Brandon Allen on the rebound. Brandon goes to the wing. He'll drive, finds Sleeper down low. He's not going to get it to fall, but he gets his own rebound and puts it back up. That's going to be a blocking call on McCarthy. That's his third. It's going to be St. John's out of bounds. Dehaney will come in for McCarthy. Ben Feldposh is going to throw it in now. Ben ends up with the ball once again, who finds Stevie down low. That's a three-point shot for Ross Feldposh. Dehaney with it. He finds Brandon Allen. Here's Sleeper, who gets it to McKinney down low. McKinney gets 2 points. And it'll be now Book with the ball. He'll go up for two and get it. It's going to be another timeout called by St. John's. The score is 56-50. We're going to take a break as well. You're watching Haslett Media Production.
It's Olive Garden's 20th anniversary of Never Ending Possible. So we're celebrating by offering you over 20 delicious choices starting at $9.99. Like our new homemade chicken pomodoro sauce, creamy pesto alfredo, and toppings like crispy chicken frita. Plus, enjoy unlimited super salad and breadsticks. Hurry, it's all never ending, but only for a limited time. 20 years of Never Ending Possible. Over 20 choices starting at $9.99. At Olive Garden, we're all family here. Breadstick lovers, your new favorite lunch is here. New breadstick sandwiches.
We're back here in Haslett. About 2 minutes left in regulation here. Only a 6-point game. Haslett looking to carry this one out, see if they can end it, put it away. Obviously, St. John's looking to do the opposite. They want to get as many points in as quickly as possible, see if they can send this one into overtime or even take the lead. Looks like Haslett will be taking it out now. Sleeper going to throw it into Jake Dehaney. Dehaney gets it over to Brandon Allen. Brandon with it again. Over to Dehaney, back to Allen. Allen takes it, he dishes it off to McKinney, who gets 2 points. That's going to be a timeout called by Haslett. It's an 8-point game, Haslett's up. We're going to take a break right now. You're watching the Haslett Media Production. back. Now, I really want to take a look at this play again. Watch Brandon Allen's selflessness. He's able to draw three defenders on him to find the open man in McKinney. He gets that assist there because he knows that everybody's going to be crowding him. He has 29 points tonight, so that's going to open up more players on the offensive side for Haslett. Here's Ben Feldposh now with the ball. St. John's really needs to get something going. And here's Book for three, and that could be the something going that they needed. Another timeout call by St. John's. I guess we'll take another break as well. You're watching Haslett Media Production. We'll be right back.
You know, the Greek philosopher Aristotle said, you are what you repeatedly do. But in our book, we say you are what you repeatedly do when things get hard. When you look at the naysayers and the haters, and there's a million of them, but you take it upon yourself to erase all doubt. Get that doubt out of here. So my apologies to Aristotle, but excellence doesn't become a habit by running the same path over and over. The excellent ones just step up to the line and ask, what's the record? Under Armour, get your feet straight.
We're back, a minute and a half left in this one. And in the second half, the story's been completely different. Brandon Allen has continued to score and score and score, while on the other side, St. John's lead scorer, Paxi, he's been relatively silent. He only has 4 second half points compared to Brandon Allen, who's at 29 points tonight. Paxi really needs to get back into it, see if he can knock down a few more jumpers, bring this game even closer for St. John's. St. John's going to be bringing some full court pressure. We'll see how Haslett responds to the adversity. Sleeper will be throwing it in. He finds Brandon Allen. Needs to get it out good before he got into the corner. Here's McCarthy to Tahaney, back to Brandon Allen. And Brandon Allen will be fouled. That will send him to the line because Haslett is now in the bonus. Or excuse me, that was the team's 5th. So they will not be in the bonus. Here's Jake Tahaney to McKinney. That's going to be another foul call on St. John's. And now Haslett is in the bonus. Here's Sleeper. He knocks down the first one. That one not gonna fall for Sleeper, and it'll be going the other way. St. John's ball. That's a shot for Ben Feldposh. It's gonna be another foul on St. John's. It's looking like this one might end up with Haslett on top. Sleeper again at the line. He's shooting 50% on the night. Haslett as a team shooting 83%. He knocks down that one. And that makes it a three-possession game. Not able to hit the second one, but a nice steal by Tahaney. He goes up for a layup. Not able to finish, though. It was originally a great steal, though. Good reaction. St. John's not able to save the ball back. Retain possession, and it'll be Haslett ball. It's going to be another foul called on St. John's. And Brandon Allen will be shooting free throws once again.
St. John's 22, Ben Feldposh, his second. He's nice. Number 11, Brandon Allen.
Brandon Allen shooting 83% from the free throw line tonight. He knocks down that one. That puts his total points at 30. All right. knocks down that one as well. Going the other way is St. John's, and they're going to call a timeout. It's a 9-point game. Haslett's lead. We're going to take a break as well. You're watching a Haslett Media production. We'll be right back.
It's another fall Friday night, and your kids should be
playing high school football.
It's a fun game, and it's safer than ever.
It's safe because the rules, the coaching, and the equipment are better than ever before.
As a result, serious injuries are at an all-time low. Seriously.
And builds.
Strong schools, lifetime memories, and tomorrow's community leaders.
And it's mother approved.
It's a great game, and we want to teach it to your kids.
We are back, and there's 43.6 seconds remaining in this one. It's looking like it might be just out of reach for St. John's to come back in this one. Nonetheless, there's still an opportunity, a small chance of hope for the Red Wings. Free throws tonight have been outstanding for both teams, 86% for St. John's, 81% for Haslett. Haslett obviously shooting more free throws than St. John's. That has really boosted this Haslett team. If they had not made those, it would be a very different game. St. John's will be taking it out of bounds now. Here's Ben Feldposh over to Book. Not able to make it, and a good rebound by Sleeper, and Brandon Allen has the ball now. And it's looking like they're just going to hold on to the ball now and run the clock out. The next time you can see these teams for Haslett, it will be home against Catholic Central. You can catch that game on Haslett Media Productions. For St. John's, it will be home against Owosso next Friday. St. John's with a steal there, and that's going to be Ross Feldposh for two, but it will be too little, too late. As Haslett gets it across the court to Connor McCarthy, and that's going to end it. The final score is 62-55. Stay tuned. We're going to have an interview with the Haslett Media Pro Player of the Game, the first ever in recorded history. So stay tuned for that. We'll be back in 2 minutes. You're watching Haslett Media Production.
It's another fall Friday night, and your kids should be
playing high school football.
It's a fun game, and it's safer than ever.
It's safe because the rules, the coaching, and the equipment are better than ever before.
As a result, serious injuries are at an all-time low. Seriously.
And builds.
Strong schools, lifetime memories, and tomorrow's community leaders.
And it's mother approved.
It's a great game, and we want to teach it to your kids.
Olive Garden's 20th anniversary of Never Ending Possible. So we're celebrating by offering you over 20 delicious choices starting at $9.99. Like our new homemade chicken pomodoro sauce, creamy pesto alfredo, and toppings like crispy chicken frita. Plus, enjoy unlimited super salad and breadsticks. Hurry, it's all never ending, but only for a limited time. 20 years of Never Ending Possible. Over 20 choices starting at $9.99. At Olive Garden, we're all family here. Breadstick lovers, your new favorite lunch is here. New breadstick sandwiches.
You know, the Greek philosopher Aristotle said, you are what you repeatedly do. But in our book, we say you are what you repeatedly do when things get hard. When you look at the naysayers and the haters, and there's a million of them, but you take it upon yourself to erase all doubt. Get that doubt out of here. So my apologies to Aristotle, but excellence doesn't become a habit by running the same path over and over. The excellent ones just step up to the line and ask, what's the record? Under Armour, get your feet straight.